Hello all, I am Disha Shukla and welcome to the session. Now in this session we are going to discuss about frequency division multiple access, that is FDMA. FDMA is the process of dividing one channel or bandwidth into multiple individual bands, each for use by a single user. Each individual band or channel is wide enough to accommodate the signal spectra of transmission to be propagated. The data to be transmitted is modulated onto each subcarrier and all of them are linearly mixed together. The best example of this is the cable TV system. The medium is a single coax cable that is used to broadcast hundreds of channels of video or audio programming to the homes. The coax cable has a useful bandwidth from about 4 MHz to 1 GHz. This bandwidth is divided up into 6 MHz wide channel. Initially, one TV station or channel used a single 6 MHz band, but with digital techniques, multiple TV channels may share a single band today. And that too because of the compression and multiplexing techniques that are used in each channel. Now these techniques are also used in the fiber optic communication. A single fiber optic cable has enormous bandwidth that has been subdivided to provide FDMA. Now different data or information sources are each assigned a different light frequency for transmission. Now, light generally isn't referred to as a frequency, but it has a wavelength. As a result, the fiber optic FDMA is called the wave division multiple access or wave division multiplexing that we already saw. Now, one of the older FDMA system is the original analog telephone system, which used a hierarchy of frequency multiplex techniques to put multiple telephone calls on a single line. The analog 300 Hz to 3400 Hz voice channels were used to modulate subcarriers in 12 channels from 60 kHz to 108 kHz. Modulator or the mixers created single sideband signals, both upper and lower sidebands. These subcarriers were then further frequency multiplexed on the subcarriers in 312 kHz to 552 kHz range using the same modulation method. At the receiving end of the system, the signals were sorted out and recovered with the filters and demodulators. Now as you can see here that the whole bandwidth will be divided into different frequency ranges and one bandwidth will be a particular bandwidth will be provided to each user. So it is divided into F1 to F12 different sub channels and the whole is a shared bandwidth. So moving further, now as you can see here, now this is a time versus power frequency and power graph that displays that when the time is constant but the frequency is divided among the different users. FDMA divides the shared medium bandwidth into the individual channels and the subcarriers modulated by the information to be transmitted occupy each sub channel. Now this is the whole figure about frequency division multiplexing. Now I have already described about it when we are discussing FDM. Now FDM, frequency division multiplexing, is a technique that is used to provide frequency division multiple access. I mean, when you want to provide multiple access by dividing the frequency, you can use frequency division multiplexing. And this whole process says that you have different baseband analog signals, and when you want to pass them through this particular communication channel, the first process that we do is we modulate it. So we have the modulators over here that will be modulating this baseband analog signals. So after modulation, we have seen different types of modulation. So after their modulation, we'll get the modulated signal something like this, and all of them will be added so that they can be passed on a particular channel. Now, when this is passed through one transmission channel and it is received at the receiving channel, again they will be having a filter. We called it a band pass filter. Each of this filter will allow only certain frequencies to pass through it. So we'll get the frequencies bifurcated over here, and after this process we have to demodulate this frequency to get our original frequencies. So this is the process of demodulation, wherein we again apply the same carrier frequencies that we applied at the time of modulation, and hence after this we get our original signals back. This is the whole process of frequency division multiplexing, and it is used to provide multiple access while dividing the frequency. So FDMA is again different from frequency division duplexing. Now here we get another term called duplexing. Now if you are not aware about duplexing, let me tell you about it. Like there are three types of duplexing. The first is called single duplexing, wherein only the transmitter will be transmitting the data. It will be only a one-sided communication. For example, our television, it will just be broadcasting its information. It will be just broadcasting the data. We cannot respond to those data. The next kind is called the half duplexing. Now, half duplexing is something wherein you can transmit the data. I mean, both the sender and receiver both can transmit the data, but only one at a time. That is, when a sender will transmit a data, it will wait for some time. It will, after its transmission, only the receiver can transmit the data, and after the receiver has transmitted, again the transmitter can transmit the data. Now the example for a half duplex system will be a walkie talkie that we use. That is, when the transmitter will transmit its data, it will end its transmission. It will tell the receiver that its transmission is over by saying over and out at the end, so that the receiver will be able to understand that its transmission is done, and then he can transmit. That is, only one user at a time can transmit. That is called the half duplexing. And the third type is the full duplexing. That is, the one that we are using right now. That is, both the user and the sender can transmit the data as and when they want. But here the point is that FDMA is different from frequency division duplexing. Now, while FDMA permits multiple users to simultaneously access a transmission system, FDD describes the way the radio channel is shared between the downlink and the uplink. Now, here the difference is that the FDMA provides multiple users to transmit the data simultaneously, but FDD is something wherein the bandwidth will be divided into two types, that is a downlink and an uplink. Now FDMA is different again from frequency division multiplexing. FDM refers to the physical layer method that blends and transmits the low bandwidth channel via a high bandwidth channel. But FDMA, in contrast, is a channel access technique in the data link layer. Now, between the different used frequency channel is a small amount of bandwidth that is not used, and this space is called the guard bands. Now, as you can see here, that we have different frequency ranges F1, F2, F3 and F4, and between all of them we have some amount left unused. Now, this is called a guard band. This bandwidth is necessary to cater for the instability of the sender frequency shift due to the movement, that is the Doppler's effect and no ideal filtering. Now, we have already seen what is Doppler's effect, but here the main concern is about a guard band. So, what is a guard band? Now, whenever you are transmitting your data and the bandwidth is divided by frequency, there may be a possibility that F1's transmission may overlap F2's transmission if they are not separated by such distance. So when such a situation occurs, the data of F1 and F2 may get interlooped with each other, and hence an error can be generated. But to avoid this, the FDM techniques that are implemented such that between the two continuous frequency ranges, we provide a particular signal. We provide a particular frequency band. Again, this is a frequency band that is not been used by anyone. So that is called a guard band. that will be protecting the interleaving or the mixing of the two frequencies. I mean the information that is transmitted using the two frequencies. So this is about frequency division multiple access. Now this technique is also used in the fiber optics, as I already said, and that is called WDMA, that is wavelength division multiple access. So this is all about frequency division multiple access whole process. Now moving on towards the advantages of it. Now if the channel is not in use, it's ideal. I mean the user, if the transmitter or the receiver is not transmitting, the channel will be idle. The channel bandwidth is relatively narrow because it's only 30 kilohertz, so it will be narrow. Simple algorithmically, that is the algorithms that are applied are simple, and from a hardware point of view also it is fairly efficient when the number of station is small and the traffic is uniformly constant. The capacity increase can be obtained by reducing the information bitrate and using efficient digital code. There is no need for network timing and no restrictions for the type of the baseband or the type of the modulation. Now moving on towards the disadvantages, the presence of the guard band will let certain amount of frequency to be wasted, because the guard bands are used to are those frequency band that are not used. So those frequencies, frequency band will be wasted. It requires a high RF filtering to minimize the adjacent channel interference. Now, maximum bitrate per channel is also fixed in FDMA. Small inhibiting in flexibility in the bitrate capability, and it does not differ significantly over the analog system. So this is all about FDMA. Summing up together, FDMA is a technique wherein one channel or a bandwidth is divided into multiple individual bands, each for use by a single user. I mean each one can be used by a single user, and in that we saw different we saw how the whole bandwidth is divided by the different frequency ranges. We also saw what is guard band and why are they used, and they are used because the two adjacent frequencies do not interleave each other. So this is all about frequency division multiple access. If it's not clear, you can ask me, and until then, keep learning.